Good afternoon. I'm Mitchell Crispy.
And I'm Derek Barrow, and this is Wolfpack News for Monday, November 21st, 2016.
Are you a senior who would like 2 years of your education at Waubonsie Community College paid for? You qualify if you meet two of the following: a 3.0 minimum cumulative GPA, 23 ACT or an 1140 SAT, or in the upper 20% of your class. If you qualify for the Lucille Gustafson Scholarship, please stop in Student Services for an application or visit waubonsie.edu/scholarships.
The lost and found in the vending machine room will be cleared out tomorrow. Students need to pick up anything they want to retrieve, or it will be donated.
Do you like to experience new things in faraway places? Do you like to experience new foods, languages, and cultures? If so, you need to check out the Oswego TAG Travel Abroad Group website to get information about traveling outside of Illinois this summer. Mrs. Stanich, Mr. Conrad, and Ms. Strass are accompanying students to Italy and Greece in June. The application deadline for Italy and Greece tour and World War II trip is tomorrow. Please see Mrs. Stanich, Mr. Conrad, Ms. Strass, or the website for more details.
The National English Honor Society works to promote literacy and creativity in the English subject. As a part of this initiative, Diamond is going to read a book review created by a member.
Amber Frosco read Atonement by Ian McEwan. The novel is set in wartime England, 1935, and follows the story of Brony Tales. Once an innocent girl, she makes a mistake and accusations that could ruin the lives of her loved ones forever. The novel follows this young girl as she testifies in court and possibly throws an innocent family friend into jail. The story is compelled by Brony's search for forgiveness from her family and of herself. It does not follow the traditional rules of the novels by time jumping and making the reader thrive for answers. If you are interested in emotional and mysterious books, then you will love Atonement.
Thank you, Diamond. The OE Film Festival will return in March. As a fundraiser, they are hosting another 24-hour film competition. Competitors get three criteria that must be included somewhere in their films, and the film must be made and submitted within 24 hours. The cost is $10 per team. There's no limit on how many people can be on a team. However, there must be at least four teams to run the competition. If you are interested, contact Mrs. Allen and J217 for more info at sallen@sd308.org. For more information regarding the festival in March, keep an eye on their website, oefilmfestival.weebly.com.
Lulac collected enough funds to buy 8 gifts this holiday season. Thank you to all who donated. Look out for staff winners who dressed crazy today, including Mr. Liao, Ms. Lopez, Ms. Melles, Ms. Schaefer, and Mr. Gangler.
Mr. Gangler. The OEHS Legacy Step Team is hosting a History of Hip Hop Showcase and Talent Show December 17th from 4 to 7 p.m. This show is dedicated to the evolution of hip hop and its tremendous impact on the expression and step. Tickets are $5 in advance and $8 at the door. Children five and under are free. Students can audition for the talent show on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 2:30 to 4 in room F133 starting November 29th. And now it's time for sports. Here's Kylie.
Girls basketball won 79-36, starting out strong against Mateo Valley in the first game of the Naperville Central Bennett Thanksgiving Tournament. Ty Battle was our leading scorer with 23 points. Sydney Schultz had 17, and Amaya Johns contributed with 10. The Wolves had 25 steals in the game, led by Taylor Peck with 6, and Jacindy Thomas had 5. The Lady Wolves also won 89-34, setting a new school record against Rockford Auburn. Ty Battle had 23 points, 12 rebounds. Sydney Schultz had 19 points and 10 rebounds. Amaya Johns had 10 points, and Taylor Peck with 8 points. Jacindy Thomas 5, and Riley Kells added 7 apiece. This improves the Wolves' record to 3-0 on the season. The Lady Wolves play Batavia tomorrow at 6 p.m. at Naperville Central. There's an informational softball meeting today at 2:30 p.m. in room C-117. If you missed this morning's meeting, all girls interested in playing softball in the spring should attend. Please see Coach Green with any questions. Join the Oswego East High School cheer team for the first Top Golf fundraising event. This event is December 4th from 1 to 4 p.m. and will be filled with 3 hours of golf, lunch, and live and silent auctions. Also, there will be several vendors there to start your holiday shopping. You can buy tickets online at oehscheerfundraising.weebly.com. The cost is $100 and includes 3 hours of golf, lunch, and a goodie bag, and much more. Please see the website for more information. That's all for sports. Now back to the anchor desk.
That's today's edition of Wolfpack News. I'm Mitchell Crispy.
And I'm Derek Barrow. Join us again Monday on East TV. Thanks for stopping by, Wolves, and have a great day.
Today is Monday, Derek.
It is Monday.